song that ever was written for this album was Death by Misadventure. It was written probably a couple of months after we finished Friendship. And as soon as he wrote that song, we knew that song was going to be on the album. It just had that feeling in it, which kind of went back to Ready Feels. It was just like, as soon as we heard his idea for the song and we played it together, it was like, there's an excitement there. And then also, it was what we wanted to present to people as far as change goes.
This is how we warm up. This is how we warm up to sing. All right.
The same prep?
Because you know when you're making the greatest rock record of heavy metal madness, nothing says hardcore like incense and a little tea.
The last two records have just been, over the last couple years we wrote X amount of songs or whatever, let's pick these to go on the record. This one actually has a plan, like a feel, you know? Feels like making a real record.
Burning down Neverland, white lines by tarver matches. Tell them what you got, what you really got.
Let me do that one more time.
Burning down Neverland, white lines by tarver matches. This is another dead body missing. What you got, what you really got.
I need the music up just a little more, or the vocals down.
Okay.
I can't hear the rhythm, you know what I'm saying? Like, the
right.
Rhythm is so in the background.
By Misadventure, tell them what you got, what you really got.
It feels like off. It feels like I'm off beat. Okay, I'll try it again. It just feels like.
Burn it down, Neverland. Skin in the ashes. One life by trouble matches. Just another dead by Misadventure. Tell them what you got, what you really got.
So you go, hi, oh, yeah. Hi, yeah. Hi,
yeah. I got in this weird mode where I was like cranking out song after song, and I think like it's very eclectic. It's like a person. Like it can jump from emotion to emotion, whether it's like angry or sad or happy, you know, very quickly, but it all has the same personality, you know what I mean? Like before, it's like I would just try to balance out poppy stuff from heavy, dark stuff and slow stuff, and this time it's like just kind of ignore it. So what if we have three slow songs on the record? If it works on the record, it works on the record. So what if we have, you know, these like heavy songs or like songs with breakdowns in them or whatever, stuff we've never done? If it works for the whole mood of the record, then just do it.
Oh yeah, yeah, there is.
This thing right here.
I mean, it could be a brute. Well, the album was definitely an introspection. And kind of almost a confessional, as if the record was my priest and I was confessing, you know, my sins, and it was liberating. It's liberating each time I get to sing a new song. It feels like something off my chest. The first album, Blueprints for the Black Market, I felt was very like, in literary terms, it was very like man versus nature, because it was so naive and we had no idea what we were getting ourselves into with the record industry and with touring and how life was really going to be. And with the second album, I felt like a kind of still into an adolescent phase of relationships, and it dealt a lot with you know, with other people, whether it be, you know, husband, wives, you know, boyfriend, girlfriend, you know, childhood friends or relationships of any type. And so it was very man versus man. And I think this one, this album is the end of a trilogy and almost a man versus self. These are lyrics. I brought five.
Oh my God.
These are all like, these are all dated. Like, started with this one starts in like. No. This starts 3:15:05. And then I'm saying it just keeps going like, then this one's next, and then this one, and then this one's the current one I'm on. Yeah, because I write lyrics on this side, and then I keep my journal on this side. People that inspire me, like old Audge. That's what we call each other. Audge. I call her Audge. I kind of like it. It feels like it's the end of the song. You know, it's more like a psych.
On that bridge, I'm like, do you think the line, the old line, would still work? The save me from myself. Because that's the melody of that, and like, well, even like the line, the hands like secrets are the hardest thing to keep for you. Save me from myself still works there. Like, the way you sang it there, like, felt so good.
Oh, I know.
With the box kind of, yeah, like, effect on it. Like, even if we put, like, the kind of floaty stuff like you were doing, like, underneath it, and then just the, save me from myself, like.
Right. Yeah, I'd totally work.
Cool.
Save me
from myself.
Started talking about this album while we were doing Friendship. We started saying towards the end of doing Friendship, well, what do we want to do different next time? I mean, it was as early as that, as far as, well, for the third album, you guys, we should maybe try and change this a little bit more, try and change that a little bit more, keep it interesting. And we tried starting off at first, getting together and practicing and trying to write together, but for us, what kind of works best is just utilizing Joey's talent, and that he can lock himself in a room for a month straight and come out with just all these amazing songs, which is what happened. I would go over to visit Joey at his house, and I would just kind of end up watching TV in the living room or something while he's locked in his room, just writing and writing and writing. And if he wakes up at 6 a.m. and he has an idea, he'll stay awake until 6 a.m. the next morning working on that song until it's just right. I mean, he's just a machine in that way, and that's the way a lot of these songs were written.
Like, they lied when they said the good die. Well, he was going
to scream it.
It would be, I mean, I couldn't do it like 50 times. I could do it like 10 with it still sounding.
Let's
do everything and then go to the chorus at the end. How about that?
Yeah, that'd probably be better. But like that one, the start with the lower and then jump.
The only problem with that like, they lied with. That's the chorus for clap your
hands. But that's one we were gonna change anyways, because it already sounded like that. But
okay. Fine.
So when you think about it, you could actually go back to the old way you sang it, because now it doesn't sound like this anymore.
What was the old way?
Death by misadventure, clap your hands now, all you children.
Oh,
wow. Swap choruses, swap them. Swap choruses.
Joey has definitely a different dynamic with me than most people I work with, because he is so just full of really great ideas, almost to the point of being overwhelming sometimes, because he just can't not have a great idea all the time, and which is awesome. I mean, it's so fun and freeing, and it makes me feel like I can actually produce instead of having to, you know, try to come up with all these ideas. I can filter through all the ideas and help, you know, the band figure out which ones are right for the song.
that I keep hanging on.
It's not that I keep hanging on.
It's not that I keep hanging on.
What about that? Try that.
Songwriting and stuff like that, like, I'll write all the songs or whatever, but I don't write anything that Dion writes. Like, you know, I'll give him a demo of the song, and, like, he's kind of the best bass player I've ever worked with in my entire life. Nobody can write a bass line to fit the song like he can. Nathan, it's mainly, like, up to him. Like, you know, he adds so much to every song. He adds so much personality, especially on these songs. He turns it into this whole other thing, and, like, he really didn't hold back this time and, you know, played for the song. With Steven, he and I have always worked well together. Like, whenever I write a song, I have his voice in my head, and then, like, to hear him once he gets his melodies written and his lyrics written, it's just perfect, like, every time. And Aaron really helps us out with that, too.
Working with Aaron was incredible. Aaron is just an absolute genius when it comes to music.
Individually, they've all grown so much at what they do. Everybody has grown a lot. And then I think also, too, as a band, they've become a little more unified and open-minded at the same time. I think they've definitely kind of found themselves on this record, too, honestly.
All right, let me just wait. Daylight when... Daylight when... Let me try one more time.
I thought you were gonna do the daylight when they said they could die young. Whoa.
Hang on. Daylight when they... Well, when has to be said twice. Daylight when they said the good die young.
Not really, if you do the they lied and then say when they said the good die young.
I don't think it sounds as good, but I'll try it both ways. Here we go.
When they said the good die young.
Yeah, but there's... Okay, I'll show you. It's not going to match up at the end. Oh, I'll do it. Daylight when
they said the good die young. I don't understand, because the whoa comes in right after that.
Why can't we go, they lied when, and right underneath it go, when they said the good die young?
That's what
like two tracks.
Honestly, the high note doesn't sound as cool, like going exactly with the guitars. Like, if you did the low and then the high, it'd sound way more intense and really, like, push out the high.
So, like, what?
Like,
they lied
like, when. Really hit the live part.
Okay. Here, let me just do the both. See what I'm saying? The first and second one of the chord. Well, it's just kind of weird. Did it? Did that? Did it? All right, pace that crap, man. I'm done. Yeah, for me, like, this record was so different. I really want this record for me to, like, be a big, like, almost like a big change, because I feel like the first two records were kind of, you know, I did the same thing on both records, but this record I really had like a feel of like how I wanted the songs, how I wanted to play, how I wanted to sound. Just being older, like, we kind of like all get along better. Not that we didn't before, but it was more like when I was younger, it's more like me and then them being, you know, my mentors or whatever, you know what I mean, like looking out for me. But now that I'm older, it's more like we're all like in it together. We're all, you know, we all understand each other. Like, you know, I know what Joey's gonna say when I say this. And you know what I mean? Like, you get to know each other more. And just being older, we've been able to, like, communicate better and really, like, on more of a adult level. You know what I mean? Not just like, oh, well, Nate's, you know, 14-year-old tour. You know what I mean? It's right. More like, oh, yeah, we can, you know, get along. We can, like, understand each other more and stuff like that. So it's definitely helped a ton.
Everyone just seemed to know what to do to make it work, to where we were all comfortable and we can all do our jobs the best that we can do them.
all.
I knew that was the final chapter in feeling like I was a complete member of the band. To actually do that and get in there and be able to record and to have tracks on the record that I played on meant a whole lot to me. And now it feels like I'm actually a fifth member instead of a hired musician, I guess you could say.
And then just as far as personal life too, just being older, everyone kind of respects me more as, like, you know, being older, and I've been in the band longer and stuff like that. So I was able to, like, come up with my own parts and really figure out, like, what I wanted. Like, Joey and I, and, you know, everyone would sit down and be like, man, I really want it to sound this certain way. And he was like, yeah, do whatever you want, you know. I'm pretty excited, and, you know, with what I got to do on this record.
I wanted to start like that.
Well, it depends on how he does it.
Yeah. We'll have to figure that out.
No,
when
no, you can't even tell. It's cut.
Is the second type longer? You see what I'm saying? Four.
Okay.
Right?
I think so.
Actually do every other go.
And the second one is.
You know where they are.
I think it sounds cooler for those to just, and it cuts out, because if it's too much, it's gonna sound like do do da ga da din da 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 da.
Like Seattle would have, like, if I would have done my drum set off, I honestly think it would have sounded different. Like, because, like, we tour all over and we go to, like, big cities like New York and stuff, and it's cool. Like, I'm like, oh, this is cool. But here, it's the only place I get here, and I'm like, oh, I can relax. I know where stuff is. Just walking around the city and, like, just waking up every morning, going to the same coffee shop and, like, hanging out. It just feels, it's, like, relaxing. And, like, the only other place I feel like that is, you know, Tampa, where I'm from, like, home.
I've spent just as much time in Seattle the last 3 or 4 years than I have in my own home in Florida. I mean, and everything's not fast paced, it's very slow. If New York is the city that never sleeps, then Seattle is the city that perpetually sleeps.
It's like basically going home to record an album, or staying at home to record an album. It's not like going somewhere, and it's just so familiar and comfortable to us. And it's just, it really inspires all of us in a way, just to sit back, because it's such a musical city, and it always has been.
It's honestly the perfect place to make a record. Like, it's just so moody, and there's such a vibe about the whole place. It felt like this, like, culture shock, you know, especially like the town in Florida that we're from. It's like, you get here and like You know, it's so laid back and so easygoing. Everybody's just kind of cool with everybody.
How you feel inside and stuff, like, comes through totally on, you know, when you record.
Very relaxing if you've been inside in a studio all day and things get a little tense or you just need to clear your head for a little bit.
It's a beautiful city with history. I heard John Coltrane was here for quite some time, Jimi Hendrix, Kurt Cobain. I mean, just people that have almost revolutionized music. It feels somehow that I'm a part of it in some, you know, minuscule way, but that somehow I'm entwined with Seattle. And we've done all three records here, and I could never imagine doing it anywhere else. A lot of the times you're almost a character up on stage, or you know who you are, and sometimes it feels like that's not me. I mean, it's never been me. Like, I love being by myself, and I love, you know, introspection, and I almost feel dishonest sometimes. I almost feel like I've worn a mask for so long that sometimes I don't know who's under it. And so that was the demons that I was facing during writing the lyrics and writing the, even my journals almost reflect that, page for page. And so it was like dismantling my demons, dismantling who I knew I was becoming, and repairing it into who I knew I really was. And same with reclusion. And that's just, I'm in a phase of life where I'd rather be in solitude. And that's kind of where I'm at. I want to be honest with the fans of the band, like, of who I am. I'm not going to put on some front that, you know, I'm this outgoing, charismatic, you know, front man who has it all figured out. You know, I explore just like everyone else. You know, I don't know the secrets of the world or the universe yet, and you know, I'm still looking for them. And though I have some of my basic beliefs and foundations restored and in place, I don't feel that I have life obtained by any means. We're not questioning God.
I mean, after that.
Just those he chose to carry on his cross.
Just those who chose to carry... That, there's not enough words there.
No, just those he chose to carry on his cross.
What about carry his cross at some
point? Yeah, what about chose to carry his cross?
No. I mean, you're taking the meaning away.
It's just, I don't know, it's either, it rhythmically, it doesn't work.
With a working relationship, you're always going to have tension in some place, because if you got a lot of ideas being thrown into the pot, somebody's going to be rejected, and somebody's going to be accepted, and somebody's idea is going to be taken and changed, and, you know, you got to just be ready to kind of compromise and work with other people. I think everybody has their own way of dealing with tension and getting rid of stress.
You know, we're five completely different people. You know, we're totally different personalities that somehow, like, have been able to stick together for the better part of like 10 years. We know how to work with each other and how to live with each other and deal with each other. I think this record speaks a lot to that. Like, it's very different, very dynamic, and it still works.
Cross.
Just those he chose to carry on his cross. If you did that, it would work.
All right.
Yeah, we were on tour with this guy, and he said, every band says their third record is their Sgt. Pepper's. And, like, I really... like it made me laugh or whatever, but you know, it's really cliche, but like I really feel like this is our best record. Like this is the most proud I've ever been of anything we've ever done. I wanna break every clock. The hands of time could never move again. We could stay in this moment for the